You're listening to the BBM Global Network with 25 years in broadcast audio and video production. Our passionate team creates content and marketing for the world of Internet talk radio. If you've got a passion, come join us at bbmglobalnetwork.com. The BBM Global Network. Your voice is now heard.
This is Evolve Wellness with your host, Dr. Nikki Herrings. Life Mastery Consultant Dr. Herrings will offer alternative wellness tools and perspectives that, when willing, can allow the challenges we face to become the mechanism that helps us grow. Evolve Wellness offers hope, empowerment, inspiration, and a strong sense of community. So please welcome the host of Evolve Wellness, Dr. Nikki Herrings.
Hi there, I'm Dr. Nikki Herrings. I'm your host. You're listening to Evolve Wellness, and we're coming to you live from the BBM Global Network and TuneIn Radio. And this week, I want to share some tools on visualizing and meditating to support you in your healing journey. And this is really, these have been some of the most supportive tools that I use and I continue to use to heal. And during a time I really didn't feel like I had very much control, this was certainly one thing that I had in my power. And I'm so grateful that this has been a part of my toolkit for many years, especially as a yoga instructor and then a life coach, because, you know, we're always setting this intention for people for healing and an intention of leading people into a space to really let go and relax and gain some body awareness. And so I had to really tap into the tools available to me on my journey. And so for those who don't know, I was diagnosed with throat cancer a little over a year ago, or a little under, it's coming up on a year, I guess, that I was diagnosed, actually. And so I had to really give myself a new north. When you find something like this out, you're very teachable, you're on high alert, your awareness is definitely a little more tuned in. So I had to really get a new north for what it was that I would love to create. And one of the tools that we utilize in life coaching is to tap into our imagination, which is one of our six mental faculties. And even if we think, oh, I don't really have a very good imagination, the truth is, each one of us has a perfect imagination. And, you know, and we know this whenever we experience a level of fear, we can imagine all of the worst things happening, right? And so that's a good test to, you know, let you know that you do have a perfect imagination. And another really important tool is to keep asking, you know, what would I love? And so, you know, at the time that I was diagnosed, I was 36 weeks pregnant and about to have my daughter. And so I just started to really envision what it would like to experience her at every stage of life, experience, you know, just looking in her eyes and hearing her laugh and the things that we would do together at every single stage of life, and creating this image of in my mind of that actually happening. And, you know, so even before treatment started, I had to think, you know, well, what would I love? What would I absolutely love the outcome to be? And obviously to you know, come out perfectly healed and really step into the greatest life I would love. And one of the first things that I did was a friend of mine gave me the Bernie Siegel book, Love, Medicine, and Miracles. And in this book, he asks you to draw a picture of yourself getting treatment. And so I did this by his recommendation, and I drew what it would look like for the chemotherapy to actually heal my body. And so he recommends crayons, utilizing crayons to do this drawing. And I found it really helpful to do even before treatment started, because I drew this picture of, you know, myself smiling, sitting in a chair and receiving this this turquoise elixir that was healing, like flowing through my veins and healing every single cell, and really just helping disseminate and release what wasn't serving me. And I just really had this vision of it just leaving my body and turning into divine love and light. And if you follow me on Instagram or Facebook, I actually posted this picture, so you're welcome to go check it out. And it does look like a 12-year-old drew it, but that's okay. This is the vision that I had and my art skills on display. But this really shifted my perspective, because going into it, I had, you know, the initial thought was like, oh, I'm going to be pumping this toxin into my body in order to get rid of something I didn't want. And that didn't feel like a very expansive thought. So I had to shift my relationship with the actual therapy. And I found this to be very, very helpful, to take a look at this picture before, you know, before the treatment would start or before I would receive chemotherapy. And it was certainly more empowering. And because the cancer was in my throat, I had to wear a mask during radiation. And this particular mask was snapped to the table. And I had never experienced claustrophobia before this moment, but I had to remember that breath was the one thing that I had control over. And so this is where meditation came in and some other tools as well. Before my treatment began, I have such a wonderful group of supportive friends and healers in my life. And I had a group of friends come over and do a little group healing and some hands-on, some energy work. And one of the women there shared with me a little card about Saint Peregrine and this particular guide. And he was super helpful for me. And I've shared a little bit about this before, but I wouldn't have even known about him. He's the patron saint for cancer, AIDS, and other illness. And he has, you know, in our mind anyway, we're thinking that he has experienced all of this stuff. So he knows exactly what we're going through. And so that was one image that I absolutely utilized, being hand in hand with Saint Peregrine and taking a path and walking this journey every day for 35 treatments, wearing this mask and walking this journey with him up and down hills and seeing the next challenges ahead, seeing that there might be some obstacles, but that there was more to the path and that we were going to get to the other side of it, to the end of it. And so week by week, I just got closer and closer to the end of that path and on this journey. And like imagining holding somebody's hand too, as the reminder that I'm not alone. And focusing on that took my attention away from the panic that I was feeling initially and helped me not think about the discomfort I was having in my throat or the anxiety in general. And so I will share a little bit more about this, and I'll share a few more visualizations with you. And if you have any visualizations that have been supportive to you, please call in. I'd love to hear your story. 866-451-1451. I'm your host, Dr. Nikki Herrings. This is Evolve Wellness, and we're on the BBM Global Network and TuneIn Radio. Stick around.
Hello, everybody.
Animal lover, author, artist, and public speaker, Patricia Daly Leip is a Renaissance woman in her own right. A lover of animals from a young age, Patricia lives on a farm in Virginia and has rescued neglected thoroughbred horses, keeping them or finding them safe havens. She is also a published author, and her books document real-life experiences that she shares in her passionate stories, taking the reader around the world in a colorful kaleidoscope of life. An accomplished artist, Patricia Daly Leip's oil paintings feature animals, portraits, stills, nature, and abstract, and she allows the brush to paint the image in an organic, natural way. A public speaker, Patricia is motivated to continually wonder about life and advocates for all of us to do the same and document our own unique history. To learn more about Patricia Daly Leip, visit www.literarylady.com and www.patricialeip.com or email her at pdleip@gmail.com. Jenny Friend is a licensed marriage and family therapist and a certified clinical sexologist, commonly known as a sex therapist, with over 30 years of experience in the field of sexuality. She's been a researcher and teacher and is further trained in human development over the lifespan. She's also a published author and a radio personality. Her specialized training in lifespan developments means she can help individuals, couples, and families through difficult developmental phases. Her primary ways of working are through the tools of cognitive, behavioral, and psychoenergetics theories and techniques. Couples, individual men and women, and families are also welcome. She can meet in her office in Costa Mesa, California, or on the internet through Skype at JennyFriendMFT. Call 714-210-9200. You can also send an email from her website at www.centerforclarity.org. That phone number again is 714-210-9200.
Welcome back. I'm your host, Dr. Nikki Herrings. You're listening to Evolve Wellness, and we're coming to you live from the BBM Global Network and TuneIn Radio. And we're talking about visualizing and meditating to heal during this show. And, you know, I really want to invite callers to join me today. If you have a particular tool that was really helpful, it could certainly help other people. And I want to make welcome, you know, the use of all the visualizations that I offer and am pulling from other sources as well, from my friends and from books. And I was sharing some of the inspiration from Bernie Siegel, Love, Medicine, and Miracles. And another really powerful visualization I got from him was this cotton candy machine. And he walks you through this beautiful meditation, and he talks about, he calls it candy cotton, which I thought was really cute. But, you know, so you're in visualizing this, you know, the stick for the cotton candy, and you're sweeping all of the illness away. You're just sweeping it all up. And, you know, while I was doing radiation, I was laying on this table that moves you in. And while the actual radiation is happening, it's pretty noisy. And so I immediately thought of that I was like inside of this cotton candy machine and the noise is encircling my body. And so the whole time the radiation was actually happening, I was visualizing this cotton candy being sweeping up the disease and again transmitting it into the universe as divine love and light. And part of my thought on this is energy, everything is energy, right? And energy can't be created or destroyed. So I don't want to just put this out somewhere else for anybody else, but I want to convert this particular opportunity, my illness, and turning it into to love and light, and just putting it back out into the universe and getting everything it came here to teach me, and then letting it go to be released. And another powerful tool that I've heard of, and I think this might even be in the book as well, but I have a friend that visualized little Pac-Man moving around her body and eating away all the cancer cells and just eating away, utilizing it as fuel. And so there's no wrong way to do this. I think it's most important that it feels good to you. It feels supportive to you, whatever that is. And so, and we have no room to judge anybody's visualizations. So I just want to put that out there because, you know, some people think of it as this battle and you're fighting and killing them. And that can be empowering to some people. That didn't feel super empowering to me. So I really wanted to think of it as, you know, really being able to release it and let it go and it being transformed into this divine love and light. And so, you know, one of the big tools that we have in our, you know, available to us is meditation. And the definition of meditation, and I got this from the Medical Dictionary online, a free online dictionary. It says that meditation is a practice of concentrated focus upon a sound, object, visualization, the breath, movement, or attention itself in order to increase awareness of the present moment, reduce stress, promote relaxation, and enhance personal or spiritual growth. And I think that is a pretty good definition. Although I think when we really break it down, it's not always that we're trying to improve ourselves. I think that can be kind of misleading, but I really like this, the definition that Jon Kabat-Zinn utilizes, or this is what he has to say about meditation in his book, Wherever You Go, There You Are. He says, meditation is simply about being yourself and knowing something about who that is. It is about coming to realize that you are on a path where, whether you like it or not, namely the path that is your life. And meditation may help us see that this path we call our life has direction, that it is always unfolding moment by moment, and that what happens now in this moment influences what happens next. And I love that because I think there's so many misconceptions about what meditation is. And it's not, you know, levitating on a mountain or, you know, reaching enlightenment per se. You know, I mean, of course, that's a wonderful goal to have, but it's really about allowing the space to let everything settle. You know, we're busy in our lives. We're busy kicking up dust around us, right? There's a visual, right? We're kicking up dust in our busy life. And when we finally take a moment to sit down, all of that dust has an opportunity to settle. And that's where the information lies. That's where our still small voice is. And that's where we might be able to hear what the next step is for us to take on our journey. And, you know, it's being able to do this isn't always easy for everyone. And I think it is because we have such a high expectation of not having any thoughts. And that, frankly, just isn't really possible. It just depends on where our focus is. And so with practice, we bring our energy and focus back to the breath. And I love the idea. Pema Chodron shares this in her book, that we focus on the out breath. If we give a gentle focus to the out breath, that is the closest we get to really letting go, to really releasing and even finding that space of kind of nothingness, that space in between. And so there's no right way, there's no wrong way to meditate. It's just about giving yourself the opportunity to hit the pause button and stop. And so I invite you to schedule that for yourself. And if you are really curious about maybe creating the imagining the life you would like to live, please visit my website, evolvewellness.org, and sign up for a free discovery call. I would love to support you on this journey. My name is Nikki Herrings, Dr. Nikki Herrings. I'm your host. You're listening to the BBM Global Network and TuneIn Radio on Evolve Wellness. We'll be right back.
Are you looking for employment and live in Los Angeles, Orange, Riverside, and San Bernardino counties? Jobs Annex is the place for you. Are you an employer looking to fill a position or quite a few positions in Los Angeles, Orange, Riverside, and San Bernardino counties? Jobs Annex is for you. Employers, jobsannex.com is your resource for career-minded people. Jobsannex.com is the convenient place for job seekers and employers to hook up and move forward. Jobs Annex has been serving Los Angeles, Orange, Riverside, and San Bernardino counties for over 14 years. Jobs Annex is a former employment search firm. We've evaluated many thousands of resumes, and we understand what employers want and what job applicants need to be successful in their interviews. At Jobs Annex, we provide you with the tools to tell your story for free. Our resources at jobsannex.com will help each applicant construct an award-winning resume, an eye-catching cover letter, and key interview questions to ask in various types of interviews. Best of all, it's free. jobsannex.com. That's jobsannex.com.
If you seek a courageous advocate prepared to champion your rights with consumer service agencies that support aging populations, Carol Ann Hamilton is the one for you. Carol Ann is an elder care coach, author, and speaker with a 250,000 hours lived experience successfully supporting uncopable aging parents. As a result of a challenging journey, Carol Ann revolutionizes how stressed out caregivers restore serenity to their worlds. She also brings over 25 years of change management expertise in Fortune 500 settings to catalyze urgent transformation within the elder care industry. Carol Ann is a popular speaker at conferences across North America. She has appeared via TV, radio, and print globally. Now you can tune in weekly to get a dose of her inspiration plus down-to-earth advice to cope with even the most difficult aging parents. Listen Wednesdays at 9 a.m. Eastern on Bold Brave Media and TuneIn Radio.
Welcome back. I'm your host, Dr. Nikki Herrings. You're listening to Evolve Wellness, and we're coming to you live from the BBM Global Network and TuneIn Radio, and we're talking about meditation, the misconceptions about it, and some of the tools to actually do it and reap the benefits of it. And I really want to hear from our listeners if you have any supportive tools, visualizations that you've utilized, or particular meditations that have been profoundly helpful. Please call in and share. Our number is 866-451-1451. And I'm listening to this Pema Chodron book called When Things Fall Apart, that was recommended by a dear friend who will someday be on this show, and I'm looking forward to that. But she shares this idea about meditation, and she shares this term, this Sanskrit word called Maitri. And Maitri is really unconditional love for self. And it's a tool that can be utilized in meditation. And so when we are sitting in stillness or lying down, whatever is really comfortable, you know, we're meeting our thoughts, the thoughts that come up, you know, we just acknowledge our thoughts with loving kindness. And so, you know, we're always kind of looking at our thoughts as they come up, and some people get really frustrated and feel like they're not doing it right, but this happens to everybody. And so when a thought does arise, we take a look at it, we acknowledge it, and then maybe we just allow it to pass like a cloud or like a wave coming and going, and we just kind of come back to the breath. And so we're always kind of focusing on something until we're not, right? Until we find ourselves maybe in this space. But as soon as we find ourselves in that space, we're not in that space anymore. And so we have to kind of take out the word try. Right? We're not trying to improve ourselves. In fact, we're really giving ourselves an opportunity to let go of control and sit and pause. And, you know, part of this can, you know, we can experience silent meditation, which is probably the more difficult and more advanced or where we find challenge. But I think, you know, with everything, it's all about practicing, maybe setting a timer for 2 minutes to begin and then keep expanding that longer and longer. And, you know, I really love the guided meditations because it is an opportunity to tap into our imagination and our psyche and visualize something. And so I'll share a guided meditation or visualization with you towards the end. But when I'm being guided in my experience, I find a deeper ability to surrender and maybe even find that space between consciousness and unconsciousness and this almost weightlessness. And I think that's why they say, you know, if you can meditate for an hour a day, it's kind of like getting extra sleep. You know, it's so refreshing. And one of the parts that, you know, when you have a really deep, powerful meditation, you know, you just feel refreshed, like really all the particulates have settled and gone away. And I love this story, and I'm going to share it how I'm remembering it right now. And so I hope it's correct. But so Mary Morrissey, my mentor, has shared this during our trainings and stuff. And she talks about Gandhi and how he, at this one time, he was meditating, and his niece and her friends came to the door and knocked on the door, and he answered, and they're like, you know, we're thirsty, you know, we want something to drink. And so he poured everybody a glass of apple juice, and when he got to her cup, he filled it up, and it was the very last bit of it. And, you know, it was fresh apple juice. So in her cup, there are all these particles floating around. And she didn't like that. She's like, I don't want the dirty apple juice. I want clean apple juice like theirs. And he's like, well, you don't have to drink the apple juice. And the kids left. And eventually she came back and said, you know, I'm still thirsty. I really want something to drink. And they get back to the table, and all the particulates of the apple juice settled to the bottom, and it was very clear at the top. And, you know, she's, you know, looking at this with curiosity, and she's like, well, what happened to the apple juice? And he explained it to her. And she said to him in return, like, oh, now I understand why you sit for so long. And I love that, the wisdom of a child. You know, all the particulates of the apple juice have settled. And for him, right, he's sitting for so long because he's allowing all the particulates, all the busyness, the monkey brain that we have is able to settle and just find a sense of peace, right? And maybe discovering on a deeper level who we really are and cultivating this thing called mindfulness, right? And I think mindfulness is really the ultimate goal and what can be really helpful in any experience we having, especially during illness or an experience that we wouldn't prefer. And, you know, mindfulness is about not trying to run or hide, but it's about being awake to the moment, regardless of what's happening. And really practicing refraining and refraining from responding, especially when it's something that could really ruffle your feathers or set you off. And it's about practicing pushing pause, like when we have that opportunity, being able to push pause and just be aware of the facts of what are happening and be aware of the emotions that we're experiencing without reacting. And so we're not shutting down or denying our emotions, but we're able to notice them and recognize them. And it really is about attention and awareness and coming back to that moment. And I love this quote from Pema Chodron. She says, this particular moment is our greatest teacher. And lucky for us, it's with us wherever we are. And I believe that that is just so, so true. And, you know, we don't have to go looking for lessons to learn and grow from, right? Our life offers many of them as we need them, or maybe even more. And it reminds me of my mentor, Mary Morrissey, when she says, the content of our lives is the curriculum for our evolution. So stick around. We're going to share some more about meditation. I'm Dr. Nikki Herrings, your host. You're listening to Evolve Wellness, and we're coming to you live from the BBM Global Network and TuneIn Radio.
Have you ever wondered why some children recover from their symptoms of autism while others never seem to get any better? After 13 years of research, Karen Thomas has recovered her own son from his symptoms of autism naturally. She now shares how she did it with you in her free webinar so that you can have the right resources and knowledge to help your child. The definition of recovery is to regain health. Karen offers this to you in four stages: healing the gut, natural heavy metal detoxification, balancing the co-infections of autism, brain support, and repair. Register now for this free webinar to help you know what you can do to help your child to sleep better, be more calm, improve focus, and reach their fullest potential to live a happy, healthy life. Go to naturallyrecoveringautism.com/free workshop, empowering parents with the resources to naturally recover autism from a mom who's done it.
Attorney Renee Marie Smith is changing the way we sell real estate. She wrote a series of books called My Short Sale Guru Guides for all real estate practitioners. Whether you're a homeowner wanting to understand the process, an agent who has been handling short sales for years, or an industry analyst wanting to know how short sales impact your business, Renee uses her vast real estate experience to take a comprehensive look at the recent market phenomena while relaying it in an easy-to-understand format. Through her company, Smith Title Services, Renee has counseled thousands of short sale participants and processed in excess of 1,000 short sales. Her knowledge is transformational for real estate professionals and laymen alike, and her live presentations provide people the opportunity to ask specific questions about their issues. Buy her books and schedule her to speak at your next event. Visit www.smithtitleservices.com or call 305-705-3428 or email her at renee@smithtitleservices.com. Isn't it time to sell your property today? Learn the My Short Sale Guru way.
Welcome back. I'm Dr. Nikki Herrings. This is Evolve Wellness, and we're coming to you live from the BBM Global Network and TuneIn Radio. And we're talking about visualizing, meditating, and really mindfulness, tapping into that awareness that we have that really has to be cultivated. It's not just a one and done. I think that it is something that we need to practice. And I also think that mindfulness can kind of be a fun buzzword, and people don't necessarily really know how to identify with it. And so it's not some out there thing. It really is something that is happening within us. And, you know, and so what does it mean to be present? What does it mean to be in the moment? And I think that's what mindfulness is. And, I love Jon Kabat-Zinn's definition of mindfulness, and he says it's like being in touch with this not knowing, right? It's like we often have, you know, it's really a lot of us, I think, and during different times of our lives, and maybe, you know, when we're really swept up in the busyness of things, we're only partially aware of our thoughts and our actions. And so when we kind of turn up the volume on our awareness, then there's a lot that we begin to see. And he talks about this mindfulness, that mindfulness is really a systematic cultivation of wakefulness, of present moment awareness. And he continues to say that this waking up goes hand in hand with what we might call wisdom, a seeing more deeply into cause and effect and the interconnectedness of things, so that we are no longer caught in a dream dictated reality of our own creation. To find our way, we will need to pay more attention to this moment. It is the only time that we have in which to live, grow, feel, and change. And I love that. I love that insight. And it is coming back to this particular moment is our greatest teacher. And inspired by Yoga Hour, Darren Rhodes, there's a part where when he's doing a Warrior II pose, he says this phrase that just always sticks with me. When we're in our warrior pose, we're gazing over our fingertips of one hand and the other arm is behind us. And he says, the back arm is our past, the front arm is our future, and we're here in the center and in the present moment, the only time where we can create change. And I love that because it is the truth. If there's something that we want to change, we have to come back to this particular moment and decide on what that change is going to be. And, when we're going into meditation, we're often noticing what we're noticing. We're noticing what we're paying attention to. Maybe in the beginning of class, it's different aches and pains and the things that are bothering us, our life distractions. And eventually, you come to the mat and you're able to kind of release a lot of that at the door and get present on the mat. And one phrase that I learned from Deepak Chopra. I got to go see him up in Albuquerque a few years ago. And I love that he says, notice the part of you that can notice. And so really think about that for a moment and really, really do that. Try it out, try it on for size. Notice the part of you that can notice what you're noticing. And, the part of you that can notice is not an organ per se, right? It's, it's really our mind. It's our soul. We can't identify a location in our body where that is happening. The part of you that can notice. Right. And so I think that's just kind of a neat awareness to take with you if you are going to practice yoga for the first time or going to meditate for the first time, to really step into that and utilizing that as a way to bring you back to the present moment, to get into self-awareness and notice where that is coming from. And, mindfulness is, again, like he said, it's being in touch with the not knowing. And so I think every time there's information peeled back from when you are in a meditation practice, the more you see that you don't understand, and I think this, I learned this, going through my doctorate program too, that the more you know, the more you recognize that you don't know. And so it's then a good practice to get back into the curiosity, to not make assumptions, but to stay in the curiosity. And I think that can be really helpful. And in your healing journey too, to just get curious, what did this come here to teach me? And get curious about what I would love. What would I love the outcome to be? What would I love to experience as I'm moving through this? And we can't just get to the other side and move on, but we take everything with us. Everything comes with us in this next version of ourselves. And so it's important to kind of be aware of that as you're going through the journey. And that helps set us up for less disappointment, but not that that's not going to happen, but we can learn to push the pause button and just recognize what we're feeling and honor those feelings and not judge them, but just recognize them and honor them and then decide how we want to respond, decide what we want to do with that. And I think the practice of meditation and visualization and mindfulness gives us a fine-tuned tool to really apply when we need that support and we notice it as, and people around you begin to notice it as well. And I think that's what's empowering, is how we can really support each other and support other people based on how we show up. So if you are interested in maybe learning a little bit more about this and stepping into that next version of what you would love to create, please check out my website, evolvewellness.org, and sign up for a free discovery call so we can explore what it is you would love and help you step into that. I'm your host, Dr. Nikki Herrings. You're listening to Evolve Wellness, and we're live on the BBM Global Network and TuneIn Radio. Stick around.
Do you battle with weight loss? There is a solution. Founder of Weight No More Consulting, Deborah Simons, can help you lose weight safely and effectively through weight loss surgery. I know. I had the surgery 2 years ago, and I am 135 pounds lighter and medication-free. This full-service weight loss center caters to your every need as you navigate to a healthy weight following surgery. Servicing all of Canada, Weight No More Consulting takes pride in its compassionate care and guides you through each step before and after surgery. Starting with informational meetings, Weight No More Consulting educates each potential client before they decide to have surgery on the health risks of obesity and the various weight loss surgeries available. After surgery, Weight No More Consulting provides a solid support system with ongoing meetings to ensure continued success. Deborah Simons and Weight No More Consulting are committed to promoting your health and wellness through maintaining a healthy weight for life.
Mike Zorich, a three-time California state champion in Greco-Roman wrestling at 114 pounds. Mike, blind since birth, was born in Hartford, Connecticut. He was a six-time national placer, including 2 seconds, two-thirds, and two-fourths. He also won the Veterans Folkstyle Wrestling twice at 152 pounds. In all these tournaments, he was the only blind competitor. Nancy Zorich, a creative spirit whose talents have taken her to the stage and into galleries and exhibitions in several states. Her father, a commercial artist who shared his instruments with his daughter and helped her fine-tune her natural abilities, influenced her decision to follow in his footsteps. Ms. Zorich has enjoyed a fruitful career doing what she loves. Listen Saturday mornings at 12 Eastern for the Nancy and Mike Show for heartwarming stories and interesting talk on the BBM Global Network.
Welcome back. I'm your host, Dr. Nikki Herrings. This is Evolve Wellness, and we're on the BBM Global Network and TuneIn Radio. And we're talking about mindfulness and meditation. And I believe one of the best ways to experience it, if you haven't before, is to take a yoga class. And there are so many amazing yoga classes out there. And if you're just starting, there's some very basic ones. I recommend just like a gentle hatha or a gentle flow or even a yin class or a restorative class. And this is really an opportunity to experience a moving meditation, because we're always focused on the breath, and not all practices really focus on it, but I highly encourage it. And we are often guided in our classes when we're breathing to inhale to move and exhale to move. And we're inhaling to receive and exhaling to release. And so you get in this flow and you get in this awareness of your breath. And what an incredible way to just start playing around with our awareness and living an awake life. And one of the best and most important poses, we say, is Shavasana, or corpse pose. And this is the last pose of the practice. And it can be a few minutes to 10 minutes long, where you are basically just laying on the floor. And you're sometimes guided and sometimes not. But when you go into this, after utilizing your body, you're activating all your muscles, you're aware of your breath, and you're kind of working out all this tension and stress to be released. And when you lie down on the floor, you're surrendering and able to get into a deeper relaxation than if you hadn't just sort of had some movement and worked your body. And I think it's definitely a good introduction even to meditation, even if nobody is guiding you. But I really love to guide my students through meditation. And so I just want to share kind of what that looks like and how you can utilize this and kind of guide yourself through a meditation if you're having trouble sleeping or, you know, you're just kind of in the midst of everything and you want to quiet the body and quiet the mind. And so I invite people to lie on their backs and get comfortable or comfortably sit in a seated position and allowing your palms to rest up just as a gesture for receiving. And I invite you to relax your toes, relax your feet, and just really allowing the space and time to feel your toes and feet relax. And then working up the body, softening the ankles, softening the calves, allowing the knees to release and relax, softening the thighs, releasing the hips, and noticing the gentle rise and fall of the belly with the breath, your natural breath. And then softening in the heart space, seeing the heart space expand and widen, maybe even expanding and widening to encapsulate everybody that you love and care about, and maybe even beyond. And softening the shoulders, just feeling them melting into the ground. Softening the biceps, noticing the elbows getting heavy, relaxing the forearms, softening the hands, relaxing every single finger. Noticing your jaw and see it soften. And soften the brow, relaxing the forehead. And then allowing the whole body to fully relax. And maybe envisioning this protective shield of love and light, and maybe giving it a color. In my mind, I see like pink and white, like a cloud surrounding my whole body, where only divine love and light can enter. And just allowing yourself to be supported from head to toe, surrendering and letting go. And then I slowly guide people back out, inviting them to become aware of their body. Deepening the breath, wiggling the fingers and toes. And noticing what you're noticing, noticing your emotional body, your physical body. Without judgment, just noticing, kind of taking stock. And then noticing the part of you that can notice what you're noticing. And just allowing yourself that time and space to experience this particular moment. And I think allowing yourself and guiding yourself through that visualization, everything relaxing and softening, that helps all the dust to settle, all the particulates to settle, so that you can be in the present moment and help kind of quiet the mind. We're just quieting it. We're not turning it off, right? And even inviting people to, when we're noticing what we're noticing, not just on the inside, but noticing the outward noises, and maybe those are also sort of part of the meditation. You notice the cars driving by, or you notice the light coming through the window, or the sun on your skin, or a breeze if you're outside. And just being in the moment, being really awake in the moment, in this particular moment. And so, you know, there are so many creative ways to play this out. And so I think an empowering tool is to even write out your own visualization, your own guided meditation, and maybe test it on somebody and see what they think, or record it in your own voice and listen to it. Because the voice of inspired insight is as loud as our willingness to listen, right? And so if we're awake to that, if we're aware of that, or if we're always in the listening, And I think that's part of it. Meditation is the listening, where, you know, they say prayer is often where we're asking for support, and meditation is where we maybe pause and listen. And so this just creates the opportunity for us to become better listeners to our bodies, to ourselves, to other people, to the present moment. And so if you're interested in just exploring some of this more, feel free to reach out. Check out my website, evolvewellness.org. And I'm your host, Dr. Nikki Herrings. You're listening to Evolve Wellness, and we're live on the BBM Global Network and TuneIn Radio. We'll be right back.
There are artists, and then there's Alice Asmar. This award-winning artist has spent her entire life devoted to her artistic pursuits and has had a lifelong fascination with American Indians of the Southwestern United States. Her book, Dance to the Great Spirit, showcases her drawings and paintings inspired by sacred rituals of the Pueblo Indians, and four of her lithographs are in permanent collection at the National Museum of American History and the Smithsonian Institution in Washington, D.C. She is one of four artists in the United States to win a Woolley Fellowship for study in Paris at L'École des Beaux-Arts, and has been featured in numerous publications. She's exhibited at the world's most prestigious museums and galleries, and recently won a 20-year service award from the Burbank City Council and the inaugural art competition of the Foundation of the United States in Paris.
Visit www.asmarart.com, www.aliceasmarinternational.com, and email Alice at aliceasmar@aol.com.
Introducing betterhomeandgarden.com. That's www.betterhomeandgarden.com with just the letter N in Better Home and Garden. BetterHomeAndGarden.com offers you the highest quality products on the market that are environmentally safe and effective, and to make them available to you at the lowest possible prices. BetterHomeAndGarden.com understands that kind of creativity and do-it-yourself attitude. Thus, we developed our website, BetterHomeAndGarden.com. BetterHomeAndGarden.com offers you the following products right online: bath, bedding, collectibles, craft, sewing and hobby, food and beverage, furniture, home decor, kitchen and dining, lamps and lighting, large appliances, musical instruments, outdoor cooking, patio items, pet supplies, plant and garden, rug and floor coverings, small appliances, travel and luggage, and so much more. Better Home and Garden is an online retailer offering a wide variety of high-quality brand-name merchandise at discount prices. Our service is personal, and we aim to please. Visit us at www.betterhomeandgarden.com. Make your home your own.
Welcome back. I'm Dr. Nikki Herrings. You're listening to Evolve Wellness, and we're on the BBM Global Network and TuneIn Radio. And this week we have kind of unpacked a little bit the tools of utilizing visualization and meditation to help us heal and really to come back into the present moment and cultivate mindfulness. And I think when you're on this healing journey, have experienced any illness or dis-ease in the body, that, you know, you start to really, really appreciate and recognize that this life is precious and unrepeatable, you know, that we don't get any do-overs. So how do we want to live it the fullest? What is our next step? What would we love, you know? And while we want to be in moment to moment, like, I still want to go out bumped and bruised and skidded, you know, I want to be late, right, for my own funeral. And so I think it's so important to be able to savor the actual present moment, you know, whether it's you're making dinner and the smells that are there, to really enjoy that, to smell that and appreciate it, you know. And my taste was impacted, and, you know, that was one thing that I missed. And I envisioned my cells, my taste buds, remembering how to taste again, and I have recovered full taste. And so I definitely cherish and savor the flavor and texture of my food. And I think it's important to, you know, take a step back and really enjoy moments of connection and carve out space and time for that. Take time to watch a sunset, and literally smell the roses, smell the flowers, and surround yourself with beauty. And I think it's a disservice if you are just to yourself to live a busy, busy life and never stop and take care of yourself and hold back. So, you know, don't let life pass you by without really experiencing the moment. And, you know, if you are interested and you're living in the desert Southwest or Las Cruces, New Mexico area, we do have this Navigating Cancer workshop coming up, and we've had one already, and it was really beautiful, really powerful, and we're going to continue to have them on the last Saturday of every month from 1:30 to 3 p.m. And it's a Navigating Cancer workshop and helps you learn how yoga and mindfulness can really be an active role in your treatment or recovery, and whether it's your journey or you're a caretaker for somebody, you know, if you really are experiencing that world, even nurses, doctors, whatever, please come and experience this with us. And it's just such a powerful tool, and it's located at Dwell Yoga in Las Cruces, New Mexico. You can register online, and it's a $5 donation. It's, you know, we really want to make it accessible and supportive for people. And so if that interests you, please check it out or share it with somebody, let somebody know. It is on my social media. And you know, if you are also really, really interested in tapping into your imagination to discover what it is what you would love and take the action steps to create that, I would be thrilled to support you in that. So please check out my website, evolvewellness.org. And I hope that there have been some little nuggets here today that can support you and at least encourage you to take a step back and enjoy the moment. And I know my daughter has really been an incredible tool to keep me coming back to the present moment. If you have kids, you know what that's like. So thank you again. Please join me next week. I'm your host, Dr. Nikki Herrings. This is Evolve Wellness, and we're on the BBM Global Network and TuneIn Radio.
You've been listening to Evolve Wellness with host Dr. Nikki Herrings. Listen each week as Dr. Nikki shares learnings from her own health challenges and interviews leaders making profound positive changes in their lives and communities. Right here on Dr. Nikki's Evolve Wellness.
You've been listening to the BBM Global Network. The ideas, views, and opinions of this broadcast are those of the participants of the program and are not necessarily the ideas, views, and opinions of the BBM Global Network Company.